Yeah, so here we are looking at the common measuring instruments, and the first one is a meter rule. So it measures length in centimeters to 1 BP and in meters to 3 decimal places. For example, here, if you look at, I'm trying to look at this length. Yes, that's around 7 point. So we write this as 7.6 centimeters, or in meters 0.076 meters. Stop clock, second one. The stop clock measures time in seconds. You can just write a small s to 1 dp, and you should end with 0.5 or 0.0. For example, if we zoom in here, this one is reading exactly 15.0 seconds, not 15. We have two types. There's this other one, still it reads time. You estimate this is around 23.5 seconds, if you can check properly. We also have a stopwatch. So this measures time still in seconds, yes, because we record it to 2 decimal places, just as you see it on the screen here. Yes, 3 seconds, 3.12 seconds. So we just record it the way it is. Of course, the first zero is representing there were 0 minutes. Then another instrument is called a protractor. The protractor, it measures angles exactly to 0 degrees or to whole numbers. 0 decimal places, sorry, or whole numbers. If you're measuring this angle here, it is exactly 56 degrees. Don't put a point anything. The spring balance is the next one. The spring balance, this one is commonly used for measuring actually weight or the force. And it can also measure mass. Now, depending on which one, so I'm not going to be very specific because they have different, what we call the list count, or what I will call just the LC. So the grams usually we record to 1 to 0 dp. Then measuring cylinder, that one measures of course volume in cubic centimeters, volume of liquids to 0 dps in cubic centimeters. Then we have an ammeter. This one measures electric currents in amperes, capital A to 2 decimal places. The list count is 0.02. So the values therefore should be even. For example, if you look at this, let me draw here and show that we have maybe a reading. So if we were to take it, you count the 37 divisions, multiply by 0.02, you end up with 0.74 amperes. Yes, that is an ammeter, 0.74 amperes. Then we have a voltmeter. This one measures a voltage, or you can say PD or EMF to 2 decimal places, and in volts. For example, here, but the discount for this one is 0.05. If I'm to choose any value here, supposing the point has moved there, those are exactly, those are 29 divisions. So it means that I can just look at the number of divisions that come after 1, those are 9. Then I multiply 9 times 0.05, I get, then 0.45, I add to 1, you get that. So that is a voltmeter. Please note this, that sometimes you will have those that have two scales. For example, this one here. So to use the lower scale, you'll have to connect it to the lower value. Here it is the 3 volts terminal. The 3 volts terminal, if you want to use the lower scale, which reads up to a maximum of 3 volts. So thank you so much for watching. May God bless you. May God bless you for following. Please don't forget to share. Share with your friends if you're a candidate, those in senior 3 and senior 4. Let them also get to know the things so that they can excel in physics. Bye-bye.